it's me, Jess. Welcome to my channel. I'm here today with another channeled message. This is a specific message. It might resonate with you, it might not. Okay, so as I was meditating and getting myself in a good way to deliver a channeled message, I had a full vision unfold before my mind's eye, complete with storyline, characters, variables, conversations, backstory, the whole works. And I want to share a snippet of that vision in its fullness here with you, because I just know that if I share this with you, you're going to hear this in your own unique way. Something's going to stand out to you. Something's going to click in for you in a certain way. I know this is not the typical way that I deliver these channeled messages, but it just feels like something will be lost in the sauce if I don't deliver this message in the way that it's asking to be delivered. And that is in its like whole very visionary metaphorical sense. So I'm going to get into that vision. But before I do just want to remind you that we will be leaving the land of the concrete, of the pragmatic, of this day-to-day world that you and I are a part of. We're going to enter into the land of metaphor. So just please hear this from that space. It's going to be talking about energy and the undercurrent that probably is flowing through certain situations in your life. And I just feel like you're going to get more out of this message if you look at it through that lens. So, okay, this vision, there's like a whole way that this kind of world operates, but I'm going to skip all of that. And I'm seeing a man and a woman, and they're in a boxing ring. They are up against the ropes and they're kind of posing with each other. They're very like clean, put together for a photo shoot. They're wearing spandex and they are just shredded, both of them. They're absolutely just shredded, which I'm taking to be a metaphor for some kind of extraordinary strength that these two people possess. It's a similar strength that they have like in each other. They're built in like a similar way, but it makes these two extraordinary like as individuals. And I'm seeing people taking their picture. I'm seeing a crowd kind of, you know, gathering, and it feels like their picture is going to be in the paper here. And the union between the two of them is, I'm hearing, like finally announced, and it's being celebrated. And there's a lot of talk. There's a lot of gossip here about the partnership between these two people. And people are very excited for what that partnership means and what it's going to bring. And there's a lot of people happy about this because it feels like in this partnership, something here about this masculine energy is like maybe older or has like been in whatever scene this is for like a longer period of time. And I can see that this masculine energy has been very successful in whatever this is, like whatever its strength arena, like this is kind of representing. And there's something about this that is like maybe achievement oriented, mission oriented. It's like he's set to task and he really achieves like a lot of things. And he's like a standout kind of person. He really is remarkable in what he's able to accomplish because of this like unique specific strength that he's very well developed in. But it is just kind of known that he's a bit of like an individual. He likes to work on his own, and that's something that he very much likes. But the other people in the community and people maybe in charge of like managing him or whatever, they acknowledge this as well, because it felt like there was maybe a sadness because there really was nobody who that was seen to be a match for him. And certainly on the level of his strength, like there was nobody for him to partner with in like a teamwork, cooperative kind of capacity. And it does feel like in this world or maybe in this arena, whatever this like strength-based skill is, that was seen as like a positive next step to be able to partner and cooperate with like another person. Because I'm hearing things like, you know, you can go further together and you can accomplish like much different feats and tasks and stuff. It's seen as like a very healthy, very positive next step in some kind of progression in whatever this is. But I can see this masculine being very uninterested in that. He likes the feeling of like achieving on his own. He really doesn't feel like anybody can match his energy. He feels like partnering up with anybody would be like a hindrance to him and what it is that he can achieve. He just really likes being in his own little kind of space here. And it's acknowledged by this group that has been around him for a while that it makes sense, because he's right in his assessment that there really has not been a partner who can match him or keep up with him or who is suitable for him. But they were always kind of hopeful that one would come along. And that's where I feel like this feminine energy enters the picture. And she feels younger in the game or younger in this particular arena. She also has a very impressive track record, and she has demonstrated her strength. It's a more well-rounded strength, but we'll get into that here in just a second. But she has also proven a strong track record of success or like extraordinary ability in a similar strength arena that this masculine has. And I think people have been watching her like with their eye on her with this particular pairing in mind for a while, even though she might not have like been necessarily aware of that. Like she was also trying to make a name for herself. She's like very strong in her own kind of solo endeavors here as well, but she has reached a certain capacity or something here where she's seen very much on the same level as this masculine energy. And there was this bridging of a partnership here between the two. And it's kind of remarkable because again, I feel like this masculine really would not have agreed to this with anybody that had not demonstrated a certain level of capacity or strength in a way that he recognizes in himself. He's really not interested in partnering with somebody that he feels like is only going to hold him back. And this feminine is seen as kind of like being a match for him in that way. And everybody's just really excited. They never thought this was going to happen. And they're just excited at the possibilities. It's like you look at these two and you kind of think, dang, that's like a pinnacle of something. Like these two can really do something together because of who they are and this particular strength that they will share in common and being able to work in tandem, right? But that's where we kind of enter the next part of this vision, because I can see that kind of like, I don't know, training begins or like they kind of start their partnership, you know, and I'm hearing that, forming, storming, norming, and performing. It's like the stages of like new partnership or like a team coming together. You form and then you storm, right? So they've formed and there's like this hopeful kind of thing, but then the real work sort of begins. And I can see that they have like a coach and they have kind of a team that's assisting and, you know, they're doing these drills and they're doing these practices. They're getting to know each other, seeing how one works and how the other one works, right? And they are kind of like bumping up against like certain, you know, certain things that need to kind of just like be fleshed out, right? And I can see that something happens here at some point in this trying to make this work situation where this masculine just snaps, like just absolutely snaps. And he goes almost into like a blind rage, some kind of autopilot here. And he kind of beats the ever-loving snot like out of this feminine energy. Like it's vicious and he does a lot of damage, and everybody that's on like the side of the ring just kind of like runs in and like just to get him off of her. It takes like 6 or 7 people just to like get him off of this feminine energy, and she's bloodied and so they're kind of carrying him off. Now here's where like I actually enter like this vision, like my energy, and I was one of the people that ran in to like help. But as they're pulling him off of her and he's still in this blind rage and they just have to get him secluded so that they can kind of like calm him down and get him back to like some sort of a baseline, I am tending to her. Like I'm pulling her out of the rink and I'm like kind of tending her wounds, and they're pretty bad. And we're just kind of sitting there in silence. I'm trying to give her space to like process whatever happened. But I am like, I noted how like strong she was. Like despite everything that she had kind of gone through, her energy was remarkably calm. And she was just kind of sitting there very, like she wasn't shaking or she wasn't, I don't know. Like she was very like kind of calm in her energy. She definitely understood and was processing the gravity of the situation though. So we kind of sit there in silence again. Like I'm like literally stitching her up. Like we're suspending reality. I don't know how to do that, but I'm like, she needs like stitches. There's like a huge gash that like I'm like stitching up for her. And finally she breaks the silence between us and she says, "All right, Jess, like I know that you have thoughts there. Like, you know, what do you think? Like, what do you make of like what just happened? Like, what's your assessment here of the situation?" And it feels like that was kind of my purpose there. Like I was one of the observers, like on the edge. I feel like I had like a very small role, but I was just kind of meant to be observing something for some reason. I don't know. And it kind of felt like I wasn't meant to play like a big role, but it kind of became obvious that maybe I would have to play a bigger role or somebody would need to kind of step in here. So I said, "Look, obviously this guy is like very strong and very remarkable, but there's a certain psychology that has kind of gone on in order to make him extraordinary and very strong in this particular way that he is. And I've never really looked at him like this before until after like this event, but I kind of feel like he's a one-trick pony. I don't know what happened to this little boy, like when he was a child, but clearly something did. I feel like he learned how to throw a punch and he saw that, even though it was like a blunt force kind of solution to whatever the problem was, he learned how to throw a punch and he never stopped throwing punches. There is a lot of nuance. There is a lot of skill. There is a giftedness and a tactile nature to what it is that he does. But essentially, he has found 300 different ways of throwing a punch. And that is what has made him extraordinary. And it's like, that's the solo nature of him, because it just feels like it's this him against the world mentality. And that really has been the fuel in his engine that has allowed him to maybe act without remorse. He hasn't had to burden himself with the, should I be doing this or shouldn't I be doing this? Or let me parse out the nuances here in this situation, like who is friend and who is foe. He just goes. It's almost like if he was on a mission and you sent him into some kind of enemy zone. Well, he's in the enemy zone. So everybody there is an enemy. So he doesn't need to be like, who is friend and who is foe? And I need to make sure that I'm preserving this and going after this. Like if it was a mission, you know, he's never had to do that before. And that is in part why he has been so successful. It's kind of this like blunt energy. It's not very sharp. It's actually not very harnessed. So I said, you know, this is one of the things in partnership where him having to partner up with you were chosen because of your strength. Okay. And I feel like that's like a variable here. You were chosen because of your strength, and every person that he's ever gotten into that ring with has been because of their strength. But I think we need to have a realization moment here where we're realizing that maybe at this current moment, like he is incapable of seeing you as anything other than a competitor. Like his brain just literally does not work that way. Like he sees your strength and he wants to partner with it because it gives him some kind of like competitive edge, and he respects you because of that strength. But still, even in this partnership energy, because it's almost like he knows that it's almost like he's in competition with you, and he feels like he's got to prove his strength like against you, and he is incapable right now of like getting into the ring as a partner, you know, and it really puts you at risk. That's what I said. I was like, you know, you are in actual danger here. And I feel like there's a lot of projection going on where it's like he felt vindicated. Again, this goes back to whatever happened to him as a boy, where it's just this, like, he learned how to throw a punch and then he just never stopped doing that. Whatever this is, right? This strength that he has, he learned how to do that. He learned how to manipulate people in a certain way. He learned how to come across a certain way. And like whatever it was, like in real life, like that this metaphor of strength and throwing punches is trying to get at, it's a strength that gets him what he wants in the world. It provides him a sense of control over people and over the reactions that people kind of have. But it also numbs the internal fear, because there's fear. And I feel like you don't look at this guy and you think fear, but that's what I'm starting to realize. And there's also a fear of branching out of this one thing that has made him extraordinary. There's a fear of being vulnerable, and you need to be able to be vulnerable to try new things. So in a sense, this partnership with you was brought together by strength, but it is revealing his weakness within him. And we really cannot be ignoring that. And I said, I could sense that there was almost like this spiritual knowing or energy that like she was chosen actually like by these people, all of us that were like around and thinking, oh, these two, you know, would team up really nicely together. Again, we were comparing their strengths. But there was some kind of like, I don't know, God, spirit guide, somebody here who understood the weaknesses that were involved, especially in this masculine, and that this would be kind of a situation where he could, for the first time, maybe see his own weakness and be able to address that, because he needed to develop a more well-rounded strength, and he could basically go no further. He has gone as far as he can go on his strength alone, and he needed to see that. He needed to see his own limitation. And his limitation is an emotional limitation. It's an internal one. And this feminine she is just as strong as him. You know, she can step into that ring with him, right? Go toe to toe with him. But she's more well-rounded in her strength. She has like, it's her internal strength, which is why spirit is saying, look, this is why I'm kind of like condoning this, but not in an ignorant way. So, and I feel like, and so it was like moving forward, I said, because she was kind of, there was a silent question with her of like, this is serious. Like, should I walk away? Like that was kind of the underlying question. And my answer, I kind of felt like, it's almost like a yes that I was prevented from saying, like, because it for some reason wasn't true. And, because I don't know, I felt protective over her. And also I feel like nobody should ever put up with that. And this is a metaphor. There's not actually physical violence going on in this situation in real life. Okay. And these are fighters, and they're trained to like be in the ring. They're throwing punches at each other. They're developing their skills with each other. I'm not talking about physical violence in the real world. If that's the case, absolutely walk away, right? But these were like fighters. I said, listen, only you can know that for yourself. Only you know when enough is enough. And when it's enough, you have to be the one to call it. That's your decision. But I will tell you this, you are not safe. This is a highly dangerous situation and you cannot go in there blind. I would say that, like, if you're making this work, this needs to be a highly controlled situation. This needs to be a highly regimented situation. It's like you guys train Monday through Friday. You're in the ring with him between 2 and 4 p.m. Your coach is right there and there's people around that can pull him off of you and who are trained to do that and who know to do that, like, at a moment's notice. And on top of that, this is a man who actually requires quite a bit of training. And I feel like he wasn't looked at in that light before, but it was because his weakness, he was kind of nursing a weakness. And that weakness had to do with, you know, cooperation and being able to work together, you know, towards a common goal that was bigger than him and was bigger than his own ego and his own achievement or his own name or something like that, right? He needed to learn when to take the lead and when to fall back. All these skills he wanted to learn from himself, for himself, because he knew that that was the person who was the best, the person who was like a leader would be able to do that. But he was too scared to show that weakness before. But it kind of got revealed here in this moment, like everything to do with that. So it was like he needs like therapy. Like he needs intensive therapy. He needs some kind of like emotional, that's his training. He needs some kind of intensive emotional training program. That's not for you to do. And we need to find somebody like that can do that. If you're going to get back in the ring here with this guy, he's got to be doing that on the side. Because that is kind of the hidden thing that's actually preventing you from moving forward. It's not the skills in the ring. It's not the backflip, kick, throwing punches element of whatever it is that you're doing. It's the internal component here. And I feel like, and part of me was saying, okay, well, does that mean that these two people are not matched up for each other? Like maybe he needs an entirely different kind of person, you know, somebody who is emotionally suited to help him on that journey. And the answer that came back was like immediately no. Like this is the person that I feel like he's supposed to be with. He's supposed to be partnered with. And again, there's that spiritual intelligence kind of lurking in the background that sort of knows this is a huge motivator for him. He wants to be a match for this feminine. I feel like this feminine had to prove herself a match for this masculine in that strength component, in whatever the skillfulness is of this kind of, you know, whatever it is. She had to work her way up to kind of like even be on the same level. It was an amazing feat that she had even done. He wants to now be a match for her in a different way. If he's going to work with her and be a partner to her and work cooperatively, he's gotta learn an entirely different thing, which is that emotional cooperation thing. And I kind of feel like he wouldn't be motivated to do it with anybody else because he just doesn't see anybody else as kind of being on his level. He doesn't really respect anybody. He wants the payout, this benefit. He wants to fulfill this potential between the two of them. He wants to fulfill that promise. But it is like he's got to then train the same way that he would have trained to be a fighter in the ring. He's got to train, but on that emotional, you know, and he's got to work maybe with other people on the side. And I think this is a masculine who likes to apply himself. And I think now that he's seen this weakness and now that it's apparent to everybody that this is something that's gone on, like it's something that he is wanting to apply himself towards, but it is going to take time and it is going to take dedication and effort. And it does need to be in a kind of controlled way. So you might be in separation here from this person. It might be a very controlled way that you have contact here with each other because he's got this hairpin trigger. And where he thinks this feminine is a threat to him. This is a masculine who thinks it's him against the world, right? And that's a comfortable place for him because again, he doesn't have to assess who is friend and who is foe. Who is for him and who isn't, who he should be saving and partnering and cherishing and who he should be. He doesn't see the world like that. He needs to kind of develop that. So it's a risk to get into the ring with him. It's a risk to get into the ring with him because that hairpin trigger. And there's a certain amount of justification because he feels she's a threat because of her strength, right? Even though they're meant to be partners. But in reality, he's the bigger threat to her. By a magnitude of an exponential magnitude. He's exponentially more of a threat to her. And I think he needs to see and honor that it's a real risk for this feminine to get into the ring here with him. And he needs to be the one that tempers himself. This is about self-mastery. This is about self-control. And I feel like the divine and his guides and certain amount, like this council around him kind of knew that he needed to be pushed in that direction. But at the same time, they didn't want it to curb him in any way. They could see that he loves whatever it is that he does. This strength in him, it is a part of his identity. It does give him purpose. It does give him meaning. It gives him a sense of himself, you know? And they never wanted to destroy that. But it's like this whole situation has kind of revealed to him in whatever way. And this feminine has freedom of choice. Like, I just think that there's just a sense that she wants this too. And as long as he's going to show up, and I just want to remind you that I'm not speaking about violence between two people here. Like, we've left the land of the concrete, and we're now in the land of metaphor. If that's going on, you cannot be around that energy. It's too dangerous. And essentially, that's what's being said here in the metaphor. And I highly doubt you've got a coach and five people that are going to be around, like, all the time to just make sure that, you know what I'm saying? It's like, we're talking about something much, much different here. It's just sort of a knowing going on between these two, that they've got to figure this forming, storming, norming, and performing between the two of them. But it's on his plate. The ball is in his court now. And I think this has been maybe a major wake-up call. But it is like he snapped and he went into this kind of blind rage where he did an immense amount of damage here on this feminine. And he needs to kind of come down to that. He needs to realize what he's done. Like, kind of in this group that pulled him off of her. Like, they're the ones walking him through that. He needs to go on an individual journey. You know, that's kind of the metaphor here. He needs to go on an individual journey to decide whether or not he's capable of, can get back into the ring with her the right way. You know, and if he's willing to do what it takes in order to make sure she's safe and protected from him. And he knows that he's a danger. He needs to know that. So that's the vision that I got. And again, this is playing out on a metaphorical level. So, and I just want to say it one more time, just for my own like peace of mind. I'm really not speaking about violence between two people in a literal sense of the word. If that is going on, it's unacceptable. You are not safe in that situation, and I'm highly encouraging you. I always have phone numbers and stuff like in the link in the description box below if you really don't have a clue about like where to go for that initial outreach for help. But there's, you know, a quick Google search will maybe give you more specific things in your area, but I'm definitely not speaking about literal violence here. So, okay. So that was the vision. Take that as you will. But that's what I have for you. If that resonates on any level, and you want to share certain things in the comments, I feel like this is a one where, it might open people's eyes to a different component here of the message, but that's what I have for you. If that resonates, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Bye.